Hey guys, good to see you again. Welcome to the video. I want to start off with a question. From broke all the way up to billionaire, with everybody only having 24 hours in a day, why do some people achieve so much more? What is it that they're doing different? How come they're high performance and having high performance results and everybody else seems to be procrastinating and not getting what they need done in a single day, even though they're putting in a lot of hours? Because I'm not saying that you're not working hard. I'm saying, how are you structuring your day? Because there's a difference of working 12 hours a day efficiently and 12 hours a day just killing time, which is what most people do. This is most people right here, guys. So high performance is not by accident. Are you reacting or planning your day? This person over here is reacting. They have no strategy when they wake up. They just say, hello world, it's me, I'm awake now, let's take on the day and become successful. How is no strategy going to create a business? It doesn't work that way, right? So this person right here has no strategy and they react to the external environment all day long. This is what most people do. Now this person over here is very, very successful. What they do is they plan their day ahead of time, right? And everything reacts around them. So let's take this a little bit deeper, right? You can be successful in anything that you do, guys, if you put your mind to it. Successful people plan their days. Multi-millionaires and hyper-successful people plan their hours, and billionaires will plan down to the minute. Think about that. They literally have their entire schedule planned out through the day down to the minute. From 7:05 to 7:11, I'm gonna make one quick phone call to so-and-so. From 7:11 to 7:19, and if you think I'm kidding, go talk to a personal assistant for a billionaire. Their time is more valuable, so they have to structure it to where it has respect for the value of their time, if that makes sense. Now, this person over here is what most people do, right? This is where you need to shift out of. To become successful, you need to start planning your day and letting everything react around you as compared to what most people do. This is a reactor. This is someone who has everything react around them. What I mean by a reactor is you wake up and the first thing you do is you go check your emails or you check your text messages. You have people emailing you and people contacting you or phone calls coming in, you react to that. Then you react to this, you react to that. And all day long, you react to everybody else's time encroaching on your time, and at the end of the day, you feel like you've worked a lot, but nothing has been accomplished. How many of you are nodding along right now? You know what it feels like to put a 12, 16 hour day in, but nothing was actually accomplished. If you're feeling that, guys, it's because you're reacting to everything around you. When calls come in, it's not rude to not pick up, it's only rude to not call back. I'll say that again, it's not rude to not pick up, it's only rude to not call back. What successful people do, guys, is they have what's called power hours, or focused hours of concentrated work. They turn off their phone, their email, and they only focus on the task that they're supposed to do and that task only. Like, if you go call a billionaire, they're gonna say, we'll get back to you. We'll probably never get an appointment anyways. You're gonna have to work really hard. Let's just say a millionaire. Let's say you call a millionaire, someone who's very successful. You're gonna have to set an appointment to talk with that person. They're not just gonna say, yeah, sure. Let me stop everything I'm doing and react to this phone call coming in, like most people do, or respond to every email that's coming in. No, they're gonna think about what's the highest value and the highest priority of their time. And if they even wanna take your call or call you back, they'll then let you know when they have time to talk to you going forward. So they're controlling their day, and these people are getting controlled by everything else around them. And this is why this is important. When you have a to-do list, and you know what you're gonna do from 9 to 10, and from 10:15 to 11, and 11:30 to 12:30, right? And you have these this day incrementally planned out, you don't have time leaks, little wastage in your day, going from task to task to task, appointment to appointment. While over here, you react to something, and then when that call that just came in out of nowhere, you're done talking to them, you say, okay, well now what's next to do? You could waste 5 minutes, you could waste 3 minutes, you could waste 15 minutes. Are there parts of your day, guys, that you're saying, I don't know what to do or what should I do? If that's the case, you didn't plan your day out ahead of time. If you're feeling lost throughout the day, you're always trying to figure out what to do next, you didn't plan your day out, and you're gonna waste a lot of time. Let's say you just did that a few times a day where you finish reacting to something around you, and then you're trying to figure out what to do next. It could take 15 minutes. If that happened 4 times a day, that is 1 hour. 1 hour a day by 365 days a year is 365 hours, guys. And if you're working a 40-hour week, that's equivalent to over 2 months of a 40-hour work week, which if you made 120 grand last year or $10,000 a month net income, incrementally speaking, if you take that savings and time and throw it back into income-producing activities that you're using to create that income all year, you can increase your income by an extra $20,000 just by saving 1 hour a day. The reason why these people are high performance and these people seem to grow slow is because they're not wasting time in their day, because they go from task to task to task to task, and they don't have wastage time leaks in between their schedule. These people throughout here are just waiting for the next phone call to come in, next email. They're waiting to react. These people are having everything react around them. Okay, I hope I pound that point in, guys, because this is a huge difference on how much success you're gonna have. You need to shift your psychology and thinking. I want everybody around me to react to me. I don't want to react to anything around me. Let's go to the next video, guys. I'll see you here in a few days. Subscribe to the channel if you liked it, thought it was any value. Go ahead and leave a comment below if you want to put your input on this video, guys, and I'll see you here in a few days.